On today's Club 73 podcast, we start off season two, episode one, with a great, great guest and some big news here at Hoffman Estates High School. We'll start off with our HEHS updates, and then we have a great, great conversation with our guy, music department chair and Hoffman band director, Mr. Jerry Lowery. And then we will finish up our show with our Club 73 segments. Hey, Coach Welbecker, you ready, buddy?
That sounds great. Welcome back.
Let's do it. Let's ramble on. Welcome to the Club 73 podcast presented to you by our Hoffman Estates loyal partners. Today is Thursday, January 21st. My name is Coach Gadowski, and I am here with my co-host, Coach Andrew Wolbecker. And this is the podcast where we talk everything Hoffman Estates High School. To start off our show, we're going to start off with some of our help updates.
Absolutely. And
Coach Wolbecker, you have the floor, my man.
So it's getting to crunch time. I know we've been talking about this for the past couple episodes, but it's January 21st, which means on February 27th, that is our trivia night. So sign up. It'll be virtual. It's from 7 to 9. So you can sign up right through the help website, right on our main Hoffman website. Get your teams together. What is it? 6 to 8 or 8 to 10? You remember?
It's something like that. But it's they just sent me the updated flyer too, and it's going to be $25 per adult.
Okay.
And then $10 per student. And then
goes towards
whichever program you are playing for.
Yep.
Right. So let's just say me and you are going to be on a team. All the proceeds are going to go to the girls lacrosse team.
Ooh, oh. We could split that, right?
You know what? I'm going to have to find out, but who knows? Well, you know, you got enough money. They call you Moneybags Wolbecker.
Yep. That's it. That is true. So yeah, you can keep it. That's cool.
But yeah, sign up for trivia night. If you have any questions, reach out and we will get you everything you need. But again, it's going to be a fun time. And I think it's going to be a bigger event, in regards to getting more money for our kids and our programs. So yes, they set it up where that is the case. So shout out to our awesome help people.
Saturday, February 27th.
Yep. And register, I think by a week before. So get on it, people. It's for the kids.
Yep.
I mean, going back to for our kids and what help is doing, they're teaming up with Garibaldi's and other restaurants and with Hoffman here. Every 21st of every month from now until May, for today, it is Garibaldi's is holding a fundraiser for them. 21% off at Garibaldi's today for our kids. Yeah. So bring your student ID. Bring your student IDs, bring your flyers. The flyer has been sent out in the emails. Bring that to Garibaldi's, get some pizza, get some french fries, get whatever you want. Our guy Steve over there will take good care of you.
And that's, again, of course, in recognition of the seniors who grads of 2021.
Yep.
So speaking of seniors, we have another recognition from today and tomorrow. Okay, so the 21st and the 22nd, seniors can come in and get their handprints on the wall. So seniors, check your emails. You can sign up. Yeah, I think it's a slot, right? You sign up in a slot.
Yeah, it's through Sign Up Genius, and I have it pulled up here. There are a lot of kids signed up to do it. So
yeah, on it. Come and leave your mark. I know in past, we kind of do it last week of school, and you come in, you stand in line. Well, obviously things are a little different. This is how we're going to do it. And I think this is awesome because I think more kids are going to be available to get in here and leave their mark on Hoffman Estates High School.
Absolutely. And it's a big tradition here at Hoffman. Did you guys do it when you graduated?
We did. Yes, we did. Okay. It was in a different part of the building.
Yeah.
But it was awesome. And, you know, like I said before, it was like kind of the year end thing. And that was kind of sometimes the last time you're seeing buddies and friends, you know, but with our seniors this year, I think this is going to be great.
Yeah. I know we did it at Kona too. It's a big thing over there too. So come in, guys, like Coach Wolbecker said, come and leave your mark here. And another, some big news here.
What, breaking news or just huge?
Yeah, I'm going to go breaking because some people may not have heard about it.
Okay, let's hear it.
The IHSA has given high school sports the go-ahead for the low-risk winter sports.
Okay.
Yep, and that is what going to that start up literally today.
Well, so the 21st.
21st.
So this is legit breaking news. Like, this just happened hours ago.
Well, a couple of days ago, but.
Well, okay.
I know you're trying to build it up, but.
Yeah, man, come on.
Sorry. So, yeah, today, boys swimming and diving and dance start.
Okay.
And then next week, Monday, cheer, guard, girls gymnastics, girls badminton, girls bowling start.
Okay. What about for the non-low-risk sports?
So the non-low-risk sports for winter, like girls and boys basketball,
okay,
they're going to be doing 2 days a week. So boys will be starting on Tuesday, January 26th. So they will be doing Tuesdays and Thursdays from 5:30 to 7. And girls basketball will be starting Monday. They will be going Monday and Wednesday from 5:30 to 7.
Okay.
Oh yeah, sorry. I think I said boys 5:30 to 6. Both are 5:30 to 7.
And those are contact days?
Those are contact days.
Okay.
And then word on the street is that there is a big time IHSA meeting next Wednesday, the January 27th.
Okay. And what will be in that meeting?
There is hope that new schedules will come out for the remaining of the year for other sports, you know, football, baseball for us, girls lacrosse, all that. So fingers crossed, not promising anything, but again, it's looking like more and more things here are starting to get normal.
Wow. New year. And there is a lot on our plate already.
Yeah. Bring it on.
It's progressing pretty quickly. And I like the sounds of it.
I like the sounds of it. Yep. So, yep. That is our HEHS updates. And we can style get into our awesome interview with Mr. Jerry Lowery. You ready for that, okay, Mr. Wolbecker?
Yeah, let's hear it.
Okay, here he is, everybody. Mr. Jerry Lowery. All right, Club 73ers, we have a big-time guest on our show to start off Season 2, Episode 1. Let's give a big welcome to the man, the myth, the legend, our music department chair, band director, and overall just a great guy, Mr. Jerry Lowery. Mr. Lowery, how are we doing?
Everybody, welcome, welcome, welcome. You are now in tune to the sounds of WJLO Radio. Coming to you live from Hoffman Estates High School, where the sun is always shining.
See, I knew this was going to happen. I knew he was coming in hot, and I don't know, man. He's going to make us... He might make us look bad.
Yeah. You know, and just to start off, right, the way you said that, you had, with all the school-wide Zooms that we've done so far this year, yeah, and you doing that voice, and it's been absolutely hysterical.
I do my best. I do my best to add levity to any situation.
There you go. and to start it off, we're just going to get right down to business, right?
All right. Sounds great.
The Club 73 podcast now has some competition when it comes to the podcast game at Hoffman Estates High School. We've had some competition throughout the district. We're not really worried about them.
No.
I'm not going to lie. We're a little worried about the hawk squawk that you are doing. So it's another podcast at Hoffman. No, we're very excited to, you know, have you join the podcast world in this game. Tell us what you guys have planned, you know, because both of us as coaches, we want to kind of get a little scouting report on you guys.
For sure, man. For sure. First of all, there will only be one Club 73. You guys, this is fantastic, man. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. There's never better than the original. So no matter what comes from this, the original is always the greatest. That's why I never listen to like remakes of music. I'm like, they're cool, but I always got to go back to the source.
There you go.
Source is you guys. So don't even worry about competition. But yeah, we were talking a lot last year about how could we provide like students with a voice, a place where they can get together and have conversations, difficult conversations, fun conversations, whatever, but really to just be heard, whether that's by staff, by the community, by each other. You know what I mean? So the first thing we thought of was like, man, the first thing I was like, oh, we could do like a, you know, like I have a video channel on YouTube. People can put up. I was like, no, that's stupid. Why don't we just go directly to the sources, man, and bring the kids into the building or into a Zoom where we're talking and listening to their perspective. So that's the idea that came from the Hawk Squawks. I mean, we're really excited about it. So we're going to do a monthly podcast. We're going to invite student guests. We're going to have them come in and they're going to talk about a variety of topics. You know, this first episode actually airs February 19th. We recorded on the 16th. It's a Tuesday. And it's actually life in pandemic, in pandemic times from different perspectives. So we'll have a student who is a student athlete. We're going to have a student who's on the honor roll, and we're going to have a student who's at risk and struggling. And we're going to get perspective from them on like, yo, like for real, what is this pandemic doing to you guys at home? Like, what's really happening? What can your teachers do better? What are the things you think we know? Or what are the things we think we know that we don't, you know, how can you help us? You know what I mean? So first and foremost, just getting them that voice, but also, man, it's going to be really nice to hear that perspective from me personally. So I'm that excited. I'm super excited about that.
Yeah. And like you said, we have conversations with kids every day, right? Being, being in your position and being in mine and Coach Wolbecker's position, but it's nice to, you know, hopefully have their voices be heard on a bigger platform. So I just want to say thank you for doing that. That's very, very cool.
Thanks, man. Yeah, I think
it's awesome that you're opening it up to everyone. And then like other students can listen because, you know, we have those one-to-ones with the kids and the teachers, but I think if everyone's involved and they know maybe other people are going through the same struggles, that'll make them more comfortable to, you know, open up to you guys. So,
Yep. And the long-term plan is that it becomes like, I'm starting it, but then I want to hand it off to the students. Like this is like going to be a student organization project they do the production, they do the post-production, they get the interviews together. And then hopefully we can get in a situation where like during study lab once a month, the school can watch the Hawk Squawks for a minute and then like, you know what I'm saying? Then like talk through it. Cause let's be real. Some of the activities we got during study labs, I mean, you know, they're just okay. So like, it might be kind of cool to incorporate that at the school wide level. So that's my mad scientist left.
There you go. Now, is it just you? Are you the only the staff member that's involved with Hawk Squawk or is there another?
No, yeah, it's a crew. We got about nine now. So okay. Miss Ahmed, Miss Pettit, we got Mr. Clark, Leo Clark. We've got Miss Drake helping out with, and then we've got Brittany Thomas doing all the like intro, outro, special effects. I'm going to have a hawk that lands on my arm, man. It's going to be super fresh for the intro.
Little Hercules out there, you know.
Exactly. Yeah. So it was just, you know, we're supposed to do like a year four project because it's my fourth year here. This was our year four project. So yeah, we're excited.
That's
going to be super cool.
That's awesome. Thanks, y'all. And let's transition. Obviously, you're a huge music guy.
Yes, sir.
So can you just explain to us, you know, how you got into music and, you know, how it pertains to your life and, you know, where it got you today?
I mean, well, let's keep it real. Like, if I didn't have music, I would not be here right now. I wouldn't be anywhere. I mean, I don't mean that from like a fortunate standpoint. I just mean like having an ability to like express myself in some kind of way. You know, I like grew up in a tough household where you weren't heard. It was a loud, tough household, middle child, all that. And the only thing I actually had was the ability to close my door, grab my saxophone, and just like air out whatever grievances I had, you know. And it didn't always sound great, but like the expression was what was most important. So, and that started young. My mom was a radio DJ for, it was before WBMX. So this is like the 70s. So she was a radio DJ in a Chicago radio station. She had all this, she had like four-foot stacks of records. And we would just sit down and play records all day long. So then I got my first keyboard when I was 9, my first drum set when I was 10. I got the drum set on Christmas Day. I smashed it the next day, so it was gone already. Yeah, I was there's no limits.
Well, that's funny that you say this. And my parents listen and watch the podcast, And I want you to say, what did you get again on Christmas? What instrument did you just get?
I got a drum set on Christmas.
Mr. Lowery, I asked for a drum set for Christmas for over a decade. Every single year, I asked Santa or whoever wanted to get me a drum set, and I never got it. So I am very jealous. Even though you had it for one day, I never got my drum set.
Mama, Papa, Godowski, we got to have a conversation. We got to have a talk. Yes.
I agree.
And what records were you playing on repeat? Give me like your top right now.
Man, Earth, Wind, and Fire was playing nonstop. Oh. Marvin Gaye was playing nonstop. You know, okay. The OJs, we had all the old school stuff, and it was great, man. It was great. And in fact, I got my first keyboard sampler right about that time, too. So I was an MC back then. I was Jammin' Jay. So I was like, we had our own breakdance team called the Mean Green Breaking Machine. And then we had a subsidiary of that group called the Dog Pound Crew. Oh, yeah, we were super into it. So, so I did. Yeah, I went to Conant, playing baritone saxophone. And then I got recruited to go to NIU to play in their jazz ensemble. And I majored in jazz studies and then got music ed. And the rest is history, man. Awesome. It's just been a nonstop love for the music, man. No doubt.
That's very cool. Nice. Going off that now, you just kind of gave us a history of you. What has been your most memorable moment in music?
There's been a lot, man, but this is 19. I'm aging myself, obviously. It's fine. But it was 1997, and Quincy Jones, literally, He needed a big band to do his farewell tour through Europe, and he called our big band. Wow. Quincy Jones and Phil Collins called our big band to tour Europe with him for a summer. So we flew into Luzern, Switzerland, all first class, all five diamonds, everything paid for. Incredible, right? Flew into Luzern, played a gig there, took a train down to the south of France, played a gig there at a band shell on a beach, took another train back up to Germany, and then back and ended at the Montreux Jazz Festival. And the Montreux Jazz Fest, it was his celebration of his 50 years in music. So there were 80,000 people in attendance.
Oh, my God.
And so I'm on the stage, and it's me, Quincy Jones, Phil Collins, Chaka Khan, Gerald Albright, David Sanborn, like all ridiculous legends in music. And me playing Barry Sax with my like two hoop earrings, my diamond stud, my Nike swoosh shaved in the back of my head. You know, like, oh, man.
Do you have any video evidence of this?
Yeah. If you Google Montreux Jazz Festival, Quincy Jones 50th, it will show our big band playing. And I actually take a solo at the end of one of the songs, and it was like one of the most, like, I was super nervous about this, right? Because the entire band stops, and then I have to play this Barry Sax solo all by myself. So I played it, band stops, and then there's this awkward silence, and all of a sudden everybody starts cheering. I'm like, whoo! All right. We're good.
I got it pulled up now. I am going to watch it right after this interview.
Yeah, that man, that's great. Which one should I watch?
I watch the 5 minute one, the hour and 30. Watch them all.
Yeah, watch the hour and 30. You can just go from beginning to end. You know, it starts out with let the good times roll, and it just goes, man. It's ridiculous.
That's awesome.
And the best part, man, wasn't even that. It was like we were in the middle of a rehearsal, took a break, and Quincy Jones, the legend, the man who produced all of Michael Jackson's best albums, etc., he's sitting in a stairwell just chilling, and I just had the gall to just sit right next to him on the stairs and be like, hey, Quincy, how's it going, man? And like, we just talked for like a half hour. Me and Quincy, we didn't even talk about it. We just talked, man. It was like, it was incredible. It was so incredible.
No, it's amazing. You went down, you sat next to a legend, right? And you just started talking to them for what now you said like an hour or whatever, but they're humans too. They want to have that human interaction and tell their story and, you know, all their experiences. People like don't realize that famous people and legends, they're humans too.
No doubt, no doubt. And you guys don't have to record this part, but like Chaka Khan was there too, right? And we went to Chaka Khan's birthday party after the show was over. She was like, what's your name? I'm like, my name is Jerry. You know, she's like, hey, you should come to my birthday party. So Chaka Khan invites me to her birthday party. We get there and it's a star everywhere. I'm chilling. I got my VIP pass. And we start talking to Chaka Khan. And eventually she makes it very, very clear that she wants to give me a kiss, right? Very, very clear. And I do not live this down to this day. Like she like leans in and she goes, so are you ready? And we're talking about Chaka Khan here. She goes, you ready? and I made an excuse that I had to be back to my hotel, and I left. Wow. I took all my cool off, was just so nervous and overwhelmed that I was like, you know, we got a gig in the morning. I got to go. I'm really sorry. And like ran out the door like a 5-year-old kid. I get grief for that to this day. That was
you,
like,
as you should.
I know. I agree.
Wow.
Yeah, it was totally a blown opportunity.
Wait, Quincy Jones, he did Fresh Prince of Bel-Air too, right?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Yeah, he was executive producer or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Yep. He did the soundtrack for like 84 Olympics. That dude is just, he's unreal. A lot of Hit the Road Jack by Ray Charles. Quincy Jones wrote that. You know, he's just got like a long list of incredible accomplishments.
It's amazing.
So that was a life changer for me.
I can only imagine. That is an awesome story.
Thanks.
And you started off that story by saying you have too many to remember or count.
Yeah. Like, how do you live life after that?
Moments in your music history.
Well, now it's all about paying it forward. You know, that's why I love teaching so much. I take all my experiences and connect kids because life is bigger than the band room. Like, here are the opportunities that are out there for you. So it's cool.
Amen. And that's probably the best advice I got from my mentors and teachers and coaches. As I asked them, how can I repay you for everything you've done for me? And every single one of them said, just pay it forward, do it better than I did. So that's the dream we're living right now.
Yes, sir.
And speaking of that, I know there hasn't been much going on in the world lately, but you know, it is what it is. So I wanted to know what your biggest challenge is at Hoffman, and then how will you continue to face them with everything?
And that's a great question for me. And I think a lot of people relate to this. My biggest challenge has been not losing myself in it all and understanding that the positive change, the positive energy all has to start within me. And I got to be consistent with that message with myself. I'm just being as real as I can, man. Like, I know a lot of people who are just like falling off or like just being enveloped by the isolation and everything else. I just had to remind myself, like, okay, this is our reality, man. How can I navigate this? Because it's not going anywhere anytime soon. So how can I continue to be my best self for everybody else? So I wallowed for like a good 3 or 4 months where I was just in a bad, bad place. Bad place. And then eventually it was just like, all right, let's take a step back and just remember to do some of the little things, man. Like go to bed at a certain hour, get on my exercise bike, you stop eating donuts every night, you know, like just stupid. I mean, just silly stuff that we just got into, you know, that was literally my biggest challenge. So like the positive momentum I've had over the last couple of months has been incredible. You know, just by paying attention to the little details and understanding I can't help anybody else before I help myself. And then that better me just is a better light to shine on the world. So that's as real as it can be, man. It's tough out there for everybody.
It doesn't get more real than that. That was awesome.
Right? Start with yourself, man. Yeah, start with yourself and just do the little things that make you happy, make you feel good, make you feel healthy, and then let that energy start to branch out to others, man. That's what everybody needs right now.
Yep. And then once we get back to normal, you know, whatever that looks like here, hopefully soon, we're just going to hit the ground running. You know, take that positive, take the negative that's going on right now, turn it into positive and make the world a better place.
Amen. Amen to that, man. I'm right there on the front lines with you guys. I really appreciate that, man. Let's go. Let's go.
Let's do it.
I wish I could make that hawk scream sound.
That's don't pretty put that, good. Don't, we might have to use that.
I was just going to say, don't put that in the recording. Sweet.
Well, yes, Mr. Lowery, again, thank you for everything you do for not only our school, but more importantly, our students. We appreciate everything you've done. And this is what you said. This is year 4 for you, right? So you're doing big things, and you know, the future looks even bigger for the music department, the band and everything. So we thank you. Best of luck with the new podcast. Everybody go listen February 19th, the Hawk Squawk. Where can they find the podcast?
We're going to have that released on various social media platforms. We're working up a Twitter account, Schoology's, YouTube's, Twitter. I already said Twitter. Might figure out how to get in some TikTok, which, by the way, I just started getting into TikTok. Good Lord.
Right?
Do you like TikTok?
I am huge on TikTok. Like, I don't make any videos, but I, you know, just going through. It's crazy.
Yeah, man. My thumb is sore.
It's yeah, talk about getting lost. You can get lost in that. There's you're trying to fall asleep, and then 3 hours later, you're like, wait, why am I watching I cut my grass five different ways? Like, this is awesome, though.
Yeah. So, yeah, hopefully a student email will go out to everybody just to let everybody know, because it's the first one. It's a big deal to us. So cool. You will hear about it for sure.
Awesome. And then, and like we said a couple weeks ago, we got to do a little Club 73 Hawk Squad collaboration. We'll have to hop on one of the episodes in the very near future.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I'll be in touch for sure. I'll get a hold of your agents.
Yes, please do. You can, I don't know who they are, but you can.
Yeah, if mine doesn't answer, you can just find me. It's okay.
Yeah. They're very busy at the moment. They got a lot of other clients on their hands. So if they don't reach back out, just come find us. You know where to find us.
All right, sweet. Hey, I appreciate the time, man. Thanks for having me on. Been fantastic, man. Keep fighting the good fight. You guys are the best, man.
Sounds good. Yep. You have a good one.
All right. Peace and love, guys.
Bye.
See you again.
Later.
And we will transition into our final segment. Thank you to Mr. Quincy Jones, Summer Ooh. In the City.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I definitely can't do that better than Mr. Lowery can. But,
I'm not going to lie. There was a couple of those questions we asked him, and I don't even remember what he said because I just got lost in that voice.
Yes.
That voice is majestic, and that's, yeah.
Yeah, but I think we're in big trouble. I think...
Not going to lie, I think we are as well. And I think we need to step up our game if we're going to try and compete with his podcast.
Yeah, we got to start bringing the noise more. All right.
All right. I'll get my game face on. We're in a lull, and we're coming out of it. We're fine.
We're okay. We're okay. Let's talk ourselves out. Yeah. You know, that was a great interview to start off season two.
It was.
Right, I think it was great. It was a lot of energy. So there's some new things going on. The podcast is a phenomenal idea with Hawk Squawk. It's something that we want to start doing too with our YouTube channel. Once we start getting back to normal, is getting out there and getting kids involved. So shout out to those guys, that big group of people. Very, very cool, fun stuff that they're doing for our school and our kids.
Yes.
But let's finish up our season two, episode one, with our weekly Club 73 segments. The first one we got is our Club 73 podcast shout outs. And today, this morning, I overheard a very cool story from Mr. Ligman in the applied tech department chair, what his classes and his teachers and his students are doing. They helped out a local elementary school around these parts with lab desks for families that needed them, for kids that were working remotely. They made a bunch of them. So shout out to those guys. That's very, very cool what they did, helping out those students and families in need.
That's for their computers and iPads and stuff. Yeah. Awesome.
Yep. So I might go down there and ask them, to make me one too. That the way he was describing it was very cool what they were doing.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Very cool.
And then this is a little delayed here, but since it's our first episode of the semester, shout out to Mr. Matthew Dowd and the Hoffman Estates debate team for taking third place at the Illinois Congressional Debate Association, the ICDA meet in December. Again, third place. That's big time from what I heard and what I've been talking about with some of the from the staff members. That's a very, very big debate meet. So shout out to those
absolutely.
Guys. Yep.
That's awesome. Congrats, guys. So our first embrace the debate of 2021. What are you thinking, man? How was your 2020?
Well, and we got into it with Mr. Lowery, but 2020, it was tough for everybody.
There's no
doubt about it, but we learned a lot.
Transition. Yeah, we learned a lot. And to transition into 2021 with things, developing and progressing, I want to throw this out to our listeners and our viewers. You can throw it on Twitter. You can message us, whatever. But I want to know, what are you most looking forward to in 2021?
Ooh, I love it. Maybe New Year's resolution. What are you looking forward to?
Yeah.
You know, let us know. What are you looking forward to?
I think just seeing kids back in the building and being able to like go to a practice.
Yeah.
Cause we haven't been able to do that in forever. Yeah. So,
I mean, I don't even think there's really a close second in my opinion. I am looking forward to a school full of kids, and I'm looking forward to a stadium full of student athletes and doing what we do best in this school, in this district, in this profession. Right.
Yeah.
But I'm also looking forward to going to concerts again. Now talking to Mr. Lowery, I want to get to a concert now.
He might be able to put his own concert on for us with all of his friends that he knows.
So yes, let us know what you think. What are you looking for most forward to in 2021? And we will get you a t-shirt. I got a box full of t-shirts here still, guys, with our faces on it.
I'm sure everyone is just chomping at the bit for those.
Yes. So that is it. That's our show. That's how we're ended up. Season 2, episode 1. Thank you everybody for listening. Thank you guys for watching. We will see everybody next week. We hope you all have a great week, end of the week. We want to say also that, you know, with each season, we want to try and get 10 episodes in. That is Coach Wolbecker and that's our goal, to get 10 episodes in. So if you have any ideas, people we want to talk to, let us know, because we are all ears, baby.
You had my contract for 8, but I guess I could squeeze those extra 2 in.
Hey, man, you're not doing anything.
Yeah, you're right. I'm in.
All right, 73ers, it was an honor. It's been a pleasure. We will talk to you guys next week. And always, and as always, go Hawks, baby. Oh, man, I can't find the Hawk. You gotta fight for off and high. Da 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 da.
I think that's good enough for season 2, episode 1.
Where did it go?